Okay, welcome all of you to the second video on design of bolted eccentric connection design or eccentric bolted connection design. So in this video, what we'll be doing, we'll be checking the adequacy or safety of a connection. The bolted connection is already designed and given to you. So you have to check the adequacy or safety of the connection to transfer the load. I'll quickly explain the connection. So actually there are two plates here. This is one plate, vertical plate, and there is a horizontal plate connected by how many bolts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bolts. And they're all at a distance of 50 from edge to the center. From edge to the center, it is all 50 mm. From edge to the center, it is all 50, as well as along the vertical distance also, they're all distances are 50. It means your pitch distance is 50 mm. Here we have written. Pitch distance is 50, pitch and gauge distance is 50 mm, and end and edge distances are 50 mm. And what are other given data are? Diameter is equal to 16 mm. Hole diameter, you know, as per the caudal provisions, it is 16 plus additional 2 mm clearance, 18 mm. Yield strength of plate is 250. Ultimate strength is 410. Yield strength of bolt is 240 and ultimate strength of bolt is 400. And number of bolts are 5. Yeah. The same bolts are rearranged here like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The same bolts are rearranged. And now when you look at this, bolts are arranged symmetrically. So therefore, the center of this all happens to be the CG of group of bolts. Hope everyone will agree with this. Yeah. So now moving ahead. So how we proceed? If you had gone through the earlier video, so this then only you'll be able to understand. If not, you have to go back and refer to the earlier video. So how we proceed in the sense, now when you look at this load is not acting along the CG of group of loads. It is acting with an eccentricity. It is acting with an eccentricity. Now don't get confused with this is an end distance. Your eccentricity, maybe I'll represent with capital E. Your eccentricity, so your eccentricity I'll represent with, so let me call it as eccentricity, I'll represent with capital E. So eccentricity is distance between, it is a perpendicular distance between the CG of group of bolts. Here we have at the center CG of group of bolts and line of action of the load, line of action of the load, correct? So where is the CG of group of bolts? See, the total width is 200 in the sense 100 from this side and 100 from this side. So this distance is 100 here, and here to here it is 75. Therefore eccentricity is 100 mm plus 75 mm. So the total eccentricity is 175 mm. Now because of this eccentricity, your bolts are also subjected to a rotation like this, a clockwise rotation. Because of this eccentricity, bolts are also subjected to a clockwise rotations, which I'll calculate as M is equal to, so 200 kilonewton into 175 mm. 200 kilonewton into 175 mm. If I calculate, I'll be getting, sorry. We'll be getting 35,000 kilonewton mm. 35,000 kilonewton mm. So it is subjected to a clockwise rotation. It is subjected to a clockwise. It is subjected to a clockwise rotation of, like this I'll write, this will be subjected to, these all bolts are subjected to a clockwise rotation like this at the CG of group of bolts. So this will be subjected to what? A clockwise rotation at CG of group of bolts. So now we'll calculate what will be the total load acting on each bolt individually. What will be the total load acting on each bolt individually? Now first we'll calculate vertical load, that is PV. So first we'll be calculating vertical load PV. So vertical load that is PV, on each bolt will be, so the total vertical load, yeah, so the total vertical load 200 kilonewton. So assuming this is to be a factored load, we'll assume that this is factored. If not factored, we have to multiply by load factor divided by number of bolts. How many bolts we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is how much? 40 kilonewton. Yeah, which is 40 kilonewton. Yeah. So we'll mark this load on each bolt now. This is what? This is a vertical load acting on each bolt. Yeah. So this will mark 40 kilonewton. This all let it be 40. This is 40. Yeah, this also I'll write it as 40. These are all vertical loads. Yeah, 40 kilonewton on each bolt. Correct? Yeah. So next is, we'll calculate vertical load on each bolt. Next is, we'll calculate vertical load on each bolt because of the movement. This is because of 200. This is because of 200 kilonewton. Now, earlier video you have seen, because of this rotation, clockwise rotation, these bolts are also subjected to what? These bolts are also subjected to vertical. Clear? Yeah. Now that load is calculated. So now let me call it as vertical load because of movement. Vertical load on each bolt. Load on each bolt. Let me write load on each bolt. Now this is vertical load because of the 200 kilonewton, and what we are calculating is vertical load. Yeah, vertical load because of the movement. Now other day we have seen the formula. If you recollect, it is m into x divided by summation of x square plus y square. So that is m into x divided by summation of x square plus y square. Yeah. Now we'll calculate one by one individually, but before that we'll calculate what is the summation of x square plus y square. Summation of x square plus y square. Yeah. See, summation of x square plus y square. Okay. Now coming to x square plus y square. Summation. See, x and y are, we have already seen, it is horizontal distance of each bolt. Horizontal distance of each bolt from CG of group bolts, and y is vertical distance of each bolt from CG of group of bolts. Now first let me take bolt number 1. So how much horizontal distance it is, here is the CG of group of bolts, and how much horizontal distance from CG of group bolts, it is 50. So for bolt number 1, x square is 50 and y square, it is a vertical distance from CG of group of bolts, which is also 50 square. It is 50 square plus 50 square. Now summation, in the sense you have to do it for all the bolts, plus second bolt. Second bolt the distance is 50 and vertical distance is also 50. Clear? For second bolt also it is 50 square plus 50 square. And third bolt. Now third bolt, it is at the CG. The CG of the bolt and third bolt are coinciding. So the distance between the CG of the bolt and center of the bolt 3 will be 0. Both x and y will be 0. Now for your understanding, I'll be writing here 0 square plus 0 square. And fourth bolt, it is again 50. Horizontal distance is 50 as well as vertical distance is 50. And fifth bolt is also horizontal distance. X is 50 and y is 50. Clear? So I'll be writing, yeah, totally how many times? Okay, for your understanding better, I'll write 50 square plus 50 square. Then plus another 50 square plus 50 square. It is totally 4 times 50 square plus 50 square. 4 times 50 square plus 50 square. Now if you calculate 50 square plus 50 square into 4, so you will be getting 20,000. So this answer will be how much? 20,000. Yeah. Now first what we'll do, we have to calculate vertical load, right? Yeah. Now you will substitute one by one. Now take care that all units are in same, all entities are in the same unit. Now first we'll take movement, that is 35,000 into x. Now first I'll calculate for the first bolt. This one I'll calculate, let me write I. I stands for bolt number. Now first let me calculate for bolt number 1. First let me calculate for bolt number 1. So m into X is the distance between, horizontal distance between bolt number 1 and CGF group of bolts, which is 50 into 50 divided by 20,000. Now, if we quickly cross check, 35,000 into 50 divided by 20,000. So, you will be getting how much? 87.5 kilonewton. 87.5 kilonewton. Yeah. Now, coming to the second bolt. We'll come back to the direction. Coming to the second bolt. Now, second bolt. So, again, the same formula. M into, let me call it as XI. Yeah. So, M into distance between second bolt and the CGF group of bolts, which is again 50. So, it means X2 is also 50. When X2 is 50, again on the second bolt also you will be getting 87.5 kilonewton. Clear? And third bolt, sorry, not third bolt. Third bolt, X is equal to 0. There is a perpendicular distance between the CG and the center of the third bolt is 0. Therefore, the force because of moment on the third bolt will be equal to 0. And fourth bolt, again the distance is X is equal to 50. Therefore, again vertical force is 87.5. And lastly, fifth bolt, again it will be 87.5 kilonewton. Yeah. Now, marking the direction of these forces. Marking the direction of these forces. Yeah. You can observe carefully. Now, these, what is that? Because of this eccentricity, these bolts are subjected to what? A clockwise rotation. Clockwise rotation. You can observe, when you apply a clockwise rotation, these two bolts are pushed down. These two bolts are pushed down and these two bolts are pushed in upward direction. These two bolts are pushed in upward direction and this force is nothing but how much? 87.5. And this also will be, yeah. So, these two bolts will be pushed in the upward direction. 87.5 and 87.5 kilonewton. Yeah. Now, hope this direction is clear. Yeah. So, you can observe on bolt 1, because of 200, a vertical force of 40 is acting downward. And because of the rotation, a vertical force of 87.5 is acting upward. Now, likewise, on bolt 2, 40 downward and 87.5 downward. Yeah. Now, similarly, what we'll do? Yeah. So, along with vertical force, now these bolts, because of the clockwise rotation, are also subjected to horizontal forces. Now, first we'll calculate the horizontal force. Let me write PH. Yeah. PH. Because of movement, horizontal force. PH stands for what? Horizontal force on per bolt or each bolt because of movement. Because of movement. Yeah. Now again the same formula. So M into Y. This time when you are calculating horizontal force, you have to take M into Y divided by summation of x square plus y square. And summation of x square plus y square will remain same. Now, considering the first bolt now. Considering the first bolt. Movement is same again. So, 35,000 into. Now, distance y. So, now I am considering the first bolt. So, y is the vertical perpendicular distance between CG of group of bolts and bolt center of bolt number 1, which is again 50, which is again 50. So, I'll substitute 50 whole divided by 20,000. So, now again, if you calculate, you will be getting 87.5 kilonewton. Clear? So, on bolt 2 also, so the bolt 2 vertical distance is 50. So, again, which you will be getting it as 87.5? Yeah. No, sorry, bolt 2. Yeah. Now, bolt 3, this center bolt. Now, what is distance y? Distance between center of the bolt and CG of the group of bolts. That is y is equal to 0. So, it is y is equal to 0 here. So, you will be getting force as horizontal force on bolt 3 is 0. Now, similarly, bolt 4 and 5. So, all again distances are 50. You will be getting 87.5 kilonewton. 87.5 kilonewton. Yeah. Now coming to the direction of these horizontal forces. Yeah. Now look at this clockwise rotation. So when I apply clockwise rotation, now bolts above the CGF group of bolts 1 and 2, bolts above the CGF group of bolts 1 and 2 will be subjected to what? Rightward forces. Will be subjected to rightward forces. Clear? Now don't get confused with this. This is 87.5 and this is also 87.5. And bolt 3 subjected to 0. And bolt number 4 and 5, because of this clockwise rotation, so these two forces are subjected to what? Leftward forces. 87.5 and 87.5. Yeah. Now these are the direction of forces. See, just because of small eccentricity, you can see the bolts are subjected to additional vertical as well as horizontal load. Because of this eccentricity, a movement will be generated, and because of that movement, additional vertical force and horizontal force will be acting on each bolt. Okay. Now coming to the critical bolt, or the most what you can call it as unsafe bolt. Yeah. So when you look at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. So you can see bolt 2 and 4 happens. Sorry. Bolt number 2 and 5 happens to be the critical bolts. You can see both the vertical forces are acting downward. Here also as well as here also. Horizontal force, one is rightward and one is leftward. No issues. But when we look at bolt number 1. Yeah. Bolt number 1 and 4. So one force is acting downward and one force is acting upward. It means force are getting nullified here. Vertical forces are getting nullified. Though horizontal force is same, but your vertical forces are getting nullified, or net vertical force is less here. Now I'll quickly calculate how much will be the net vertical force here. Both are acting downward. It is 87.5 plus 40. That is total will be 127.5, and horizontal force of 87.5. Yeah, when you look at bolt number 1, one is 40 and another one is 87.5. And net force will be how much? 37.5 in the upward direction. So net force will be, net vertical will be 37.5 in the upward direction. Now this will not happen to be the critical bolt. Clear? So wherever the resultant are adding up, the net forces are increasing. So that will become the critical bolt. Now here also bolt number 5 also, the net vertical force is 127.5. Now center bolt, it is only the vertical force. There is no additional forces coming. Clear? Now bolt 2 and 5 happens to be the critical bolt. Now in the next step, what we'll do, we'll calculate net force on critical bolt. Net force on critical bolt, either bolt number 2 or 5. Both are one and the same. Bolt number 2 or 5. So I'll quickly rewrite bolt number 2. Now if you recollect, what are the forces? 40 and 87.5. 40 and 87.5. And what is the other force? Yeah. Horizontal force of 87.5. Yeah. Now this is bolt number 2. And same with bolt number 5 also. Let me write bolt number. Yeah. We'll take only bolt number 2. Both are same. Yeah. So I'll write the net force. This bolt will be subjected to what? 127.5 kilonewton and 87.5 kilonewton. Yeah, this will be the net force subjected. Now, how do you find the resultant of both the forces? Yeah, the net resultant force because of horizontal force and vertical force will be 127.5. Resultant force on bolt 2 will be 127.5 square plus 87.5 square. Under root. Clear? So if you calculate, 127.5 square plus 87.5 square under root, if you calculate, so you will be getting how much? 154.63 kilonewton. Now this will be the force, this much intensity is the force acting on D. this bolt. Clear? Now, now what you have to do, now this is the force acting on one bolt now, or the critical bolt. This will be the maximum force acting on, the resultant force acting on one bolt or the critical bolt. Now what you have to do, you have to calculate the design strength of one bolt now. Design strength of one bolt. You have to calculate design strength of one bolt. Now quickly, how do you calculate design strength? It is a lap joint. This is a lap joint. Now lap joint connection of two plates, it will be subjected to what? And the plate thickness, I forgot to mention, T1 is also 10 mm and T2 is also 10 mm. T1 is also 10 mm, sorry. Let me take T1 is 10 and T2 is 12 mm. Now it is lap joint connection of two plates. So this will be subjected to single shear. Now directly I'll calculate. Now as per, if you recollect 10.3.3, the VDSB is equal to VNSB divided by gamma MB. And what is VNSB stands for? FU by root 3 NN into ANB plus NS into ASB. Correct? So we'll assume NN is equal to 1 single shear and NS is equal to 0. Clear? FUB. Now quickly, 400 divided by root 3. So NN is 1 we have taken, and this will be 0.78 times of what is 16 mm dia. So if dia is 16, B is 16 mm. So ASB you can calculate, it is roughly around 201 square mm points. ASB, and ANB will be how much? 0.78 times of 201. Now quickly, if you calculate, it is 0.78 into 201 into 400 divided by root 3. So you will be getting how much? Divided by 1000 to convert it to kilonewton, you will be getting how much? 36.206 kilonewton. And VDSB, that is VNSB, 36.206 divided by 1.25. So you'll be getting 28.97 kilonewton. This is shear capacity. You can box this value. Next is bearing capacity. As per 10.3.4, this is shear capacity. And next is bearing capacity. Now what is the formula says? VDPB is equal to VNPB divided by gamma MB. I'll quickly write down VNPB. It says 2.5 kb dt into FU. So I'll substitute 1 by 1, 2.5 kb we have to calculate, d is 16, t is lesser of 10 n, t is lesser of 10 and 12. I'll write 10 here and 400. Now kb we have to calculate. So kb is e by 3d naught and p by 3d naught minus 0.25 and other two values. Now e is already given 50 divided by 3d naught is 54. That is 50 divided by 54.92. 0.92. Now coming to this, 50 divided by, I think this is p by, just a minute, I'll check. P by, what is the formula? I forgot. Okay, this is p by 3d naught, 3d naught being 54 minus 0.25. So which will be 0.92. No, 0.92 minus 0.25, which is 0.67. 0.67. The other two values will be definitely greater than. And KB happens to be 0.67. Now, if you calculate further, it is 2.5 into 0.67 into 16 into 10 into 400. Yeah, it is 107.2 2 kilo Newton. And DPB, it is 107.2 divided by 1.25 divided by 1.25. It is 85.76 kilonewton. Now we have two values. One is bearing capacity, other one is shearing. So lesser of those two will be the design shear capacity, that is 28.97. So design capacity, I'll write here. So design capacity is 28.97 kilonewton. Yeah. So what does that mean? So the material, the bolt will fail at 28.97. But what is the maximum load coming on the critical bolt? 154. Clear? Now bolt is failing at 28.97, whereas a load of 154.63 kilonewton is coming. So it means, so capacity is less than the load. Therefore, it is unsafe or inadequate. You can write unsafe or inadequate connection. If this is say 160, if design strength is say 160, so which will be greater than the maximum force on one bolt, one critical bolt? Clear? So then this would have been safe. Clear? Then this would have been safe. Now in our case, this is unsafe.